This is the Putrajaya Mass Rapid Transit Line 2, and it is a 57.7-kilometer mega-urban rail project located in the Klang Valley area of Malaysia. This massive transportation plan is estimated to cost a whopping 30 billion ringgit, making it one of the most expensive transit lines to be ever constructed in Malaysia. This Mass Rapid Master Plan is the third Mass Rapid Transit or MRT line and the fourth to be ever constructed as an automated and driverless rail system in the Klang Valley area. With a total line length of over 57.7 kilometers and a total of 37 stations, of which 13.5 kilometers of track and 11 stations would be underground. The rolling stock that would be used for this line is constructed from a consortium composed of a majority of South Korean firms, notably the Hyundai Rotem and POSCO Engineering. As this is an automated system, the trains would be driverless, increasing the efficiency of this program and decreasing the need for human interaction jobs. A total of 49 four-car train sets would be used and will run at a maximum speed of 100 kilometers per hour, and will accommodate over 1,200 people. This would then add up to 533,000 daily passengers. These stocks would be housed in the Klang Valley Sungai Buloh Depot, which is in fact the largest train depot in the entire Southeast Asia region. It stands on 162 acres of land, which can park 66 trains. They constructed this depot alone to handle a capacity of serving a million mass rapid transit passengers a day, which makes it one of Malaysia's renowned projects. The Putrajaya MRT Line 2 will be developed into two phases. The first phase, which is already expected to be operational by November 2021. This segment of the construction starts from Kuala Damansara Station all the way to Kampung Batu. The second phase, which is slated for completion by 2023, starts from Kentonmen Station and ends at Putrajaya Central. This is also planned to be connected with a future project called the Putrajaya Monorail. The estimated cost of this mega project was at first estimated to be over 40 billion ringgit. Eventually, though, the construction was lowered to only 30 billion, cutting the project cost over 20%. This resulted in only costing 13 billion ringgit in underground construction using tunnel boring machines or TBM and 17 billion for above groundworks. Exchanged to United States dollars, this mega project is at over $7.1 billion, which truly sets a standard for the country and its neighbors for continuous infrastructure development into future use. If that does not sound like a lot, we can compare the Putrajaya city itself, which was planned just in 1995 and was Malaysia's largest project at that time, along with it being one of the largest in Southeast Asia. It was constructed at $8.1 billion, or around $14 billion adjusted for inflation. That would mean that the MRT Line 2 is half the cost of this previous magnificent project of Malaysia. Utilizing state-of-the-art technologies throughout the project is what transformed this project into a unique infrastructure. Digging tunnels is hard, but in today's time, and especially what they used within the Putrajaya project, is what essentially boosted its project timeline. The so-called world's first autonomous tunnel boring machine by ATBM simplified and made it a lot safer for this mega project. The use of vast information systems, augmented reality, and artificial intelligence essentially helped drive down the construction price and ensured a much better and safer project for both the riders and constructors. The project was constructed with the help of several companies within Malaysia and from around the world. However, the most significant leading company was the MMC Garuda, a joint venture between two of Malaysia's largest engineering constructions. Through this company, they have ensured that this new MRT line will be a local-style design, from both its interior to its exterior, whether it be the underground stations or elevated ones. They worked hard to show the world that this is the work of thousands of Malaysians. So much so that its stations had won numerous architectural awards from various governing bodies. It was noted that this project was perfectly balanced between cost, constructability, maintenance, computer convenience, and safety, and all ensured that there is that Malaysian touch within it. The recent pandemic wreaked havoc on each country's economy around the world. The opening of the Putrajaya MRT line, as the transport minister noted, that it was such a necessity for the country to have. To ensure the recovery of the country, along with newer sectors opening because of the lockdown's effect on the e-commerce industry, this project will ensure that Malaysia is one step ahead of its economic battle against the recent recessions. Anyway, what do you think about Malaysia's new Putrajaya Mass Rapid Transit Line? Share with us your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to leave us a like and follow us for more amazing videos. Thanks for watching.